controls. He could crush all opposition and make me the most powerful man in the world.
All right, we're ready to get started. So we are playing Marvel vs. Capcom. And this is Marvel vs. Capcom 1, but it's really the third Marvel and Capcom versus game. We did X-Men vs. Street Fighter, Marvel Super Heroes vs. Street Fighter, and then some of the same characters show up. This is Marvel vs. Capcom. Opens it up to more Capcom characters, as you can see. Captain Commando, we may remember him from a few streams ago. And a lot of few characters that were used before, and then there's some totally new ones like Venom. And this was a big deal when it came out. I like this one a little more than Marvel 2 for some reason. So this was not... I don't know, I could be wrong. This one doesn't seem as broken to me. I guess because there's fewer characters. It's still 2 versus 2. It does have assists, but they're dedicated assists. They're basically at random. There are a few like button codes you can hold down, like you can get some secret assists, or you can keep getting the good ones like Colossus or I guess Juggernaut's okay, Psylocke, the tanks that kind of fly across the screen, Sentinel. And I think there's some secret characters, secret assists, they're really just recolors of regular people, like Charlie from Street Fighter Alpha's in the game. He's like a shadow character. Or he's the assist. He's just called Shadow. And then the Shadow Lady is Chun-Li with a bunch of weird moves. And then there's Red Venom, which I guess is supposed to be Carnage. He's just his speed-up character. Maybe some others I'm forgetting. But this one's fun. Maybe I'll do it. Couple of playthroughs of this. Try Wolverine and Strider. Team stab. We can stab some people.
Let's go, Bob.
Ready. Fight.
Psylocke there. She's a pretty good assist. It's a little overkill and unnecessary, but just want to show off the team up. Oops, press the button. I want to show off the team up attack. Oh yeah, stick with the Marvel theme. Got my Thanos coffee.
Let's go, Bob.
Ready. Fight.
Oh.
Come on.
a lot of fanfare for one hit. So this one does have the duo team attacks, which I guess kind of come back in Marvel Infinite, but takes three bars. You get both characters on the screen at the same time, and you control both at the same time too, and you have unlimited super bars, so if you can make that happen, you can totally wreck. Like sometimes trap people with unblockable or almost unblockable setups. I recall there being some sort of secrets. If you go through without getting a character KO'd, and you do so many KOs with supers, you fight some secret characters. I don't really remember all the setups, but I think if you just don't get knocked out, you'll fight somebody. Colossus is the godlike assist. If you're playing for real and you actually want to pick an assist, you want Colossus. That's right. You tell him Strider. Tell him that thing.
Let's go, Bub.
Stereo Bub. I feel like the moves in this one do the most damage, though. These matches feel extremely short, especially compared to the newer games.
Let's go, Bob.
Ready. Fight!
Yeah, just remember. You have to hit start so you can keep beating on their unconscious body. Oh, secret character. So, Gold War Machine, I believe. He can't block, but he does a lot of damage. And you can't combo him. He's just a tank. Nothing would work. Strider, heal you. Win.
Let's go, Bob.
Ready. Fight.
Out. Oh, that's Onslaught. This is probably the hardest boss in the versus games, I think, because it can take you out in one or two hits if you're not careful.
Ready. Fight.
Hey, my back. You're my patron.
So two forearms. That one's hard enough. Big boy is even harder.
No one is.
That is why he's so hard. Those damn laser blasts. I don't remember how to do his X Lightning Super. That's about the only one that'll hit him. So let's try that again.
Let's go, Bob.
I am Onslaught.
Little better that time.
No one is.
Oh shit. Well, so much for doing better. Cannot remember how to do that super in this game. Alright, we're good for sure this time. This is what makes him so hard. You just don't block or get crossed up at the wrong time and you're dead. Also, not knowing, I cannot remember Wolverine's X super.
I
Can't get killed by the first form, that's terrible.
No one is. I reject your
Wow.
The dream is dead.
I haven't played this in a long time. This may be the worst I've ever done. Bomb to the face.
KO! Strider, heal you. Win.
Save the world, ride a whale. Why not? So yeah, this one's a little bit of a step up from the previous two games, I think. This one's still probably one of my favorite ones. It's all hand-drawn 2D still. Marvel 2 still is, but it has those weird 2D backgrounds I'm not too much of a fan of. And the terrible music. This one still kind of has that retro feel to it, even though it doesn't have as big of a roster. And also, on the home versions, I have the Dreamcast one. That was probably the only decent way to play it that I recall. It had four controller ports, so you could actually have a four-player mode, and four people be in the room and when you tag in, whoever was, you know, the second teammate would take over. It was a cool little feature. I think they brought it back some for the newer games when you play online.
Controls, I could crush all opposition and make me the most powerful man in the world.